Hi guys, Claire here, and look what I have. It is the Margaret Rudkin Pepperidge Farm Cookbook. And I actually got this from Bonnie Slotnick in New York. It was pretty funny. I was shopping in her store and she went, oh, well, you have the Pepperidge Farm Cookbook, so hold on, let me get you something else. And I was like, oh, no, I don't. And she was shocked. And so she shoved this into my hands and now I have it and I love it. Hi. Sorry, that's Mochi in the background, obviously. What's up? What I love about this book is kind of this notion that Pepperidge Farm actually has a story. It's not this like made up corporation. It has a history, and Margaret Rudkin is that history. Similarly, Toll House, for instance, like Toll House Cookies, it was an actual inn. And in 1936, it invented the chocolate chip cookie, or at least got credit for inventing it. So it's interesting. There is this history to food and where it comes from, even on the kind of mass market scale as well. But what I love about this book, it was published in 1963. The illustrations are really beautiful. They're all color illustrations. And I love the way it's organized. So first it says, to Henry, the most patient man in the world, which I love. And the foreword's great. Margaret Rudkin's just like, seems like a lovely person. Why, oh why, did I ever think I could write a book? That's what I've been saying to myself for a long time. It was always easy enough for me to talk about food and recipes and all the fun and excitement I've had in my life, especially in the past 25 years with the development of the Pepperidge Farm Company. When so many of my misguided friends kept saying, just write it all in a book, it seemed easy enough to do, but alas, I have learned the difference between talking and writing. As someone who has written a cookbook, I can completely say, yes, I understand that. I love the way this book is organized. So usually cookbooks are organized by breakfast, lunch, dinner, or like flavor profiles or ingredients. This one is organized biographically. So she has recipes pertaining to childhood, country life, Pepperidge Farm, and cooking from antique cookbooks, and then Ireland, which I think is just lovely. I love that idea. It forces it to be immensely personal, and there's just so much in here that is biographical or autobiographical, where she talks about her life, her childhood, her grandparents, and I've actually started flagging some that sound really interesting. One recipe in particular that I'm very curious about is from the chapter titled Country Life. It just says strawberries. The recipe is just 2 quarts of strawberries, 1 12-ounce jar of strawberry jam, and then 1/4 cup of kirsch liqueur. And so you just kind of wash and stem the strawberries and you mix everything together. Simple enough, so it kind of macerates the strawberries. The white custard cream though is really interesting. So you combine egg whites, heavy cream, some other business, and you boil it together while whipping it. So it's a boiled cream, but I wonder what that must taste like. It sounds really good. Like, I love meringue, I love whipped cream, and kind of putting them together sounds like it could be really good. This book is so charming. It's filled with recipes. Most of them are very simple, very ingredient driven, and honestly to me, like excluding references to things like kirsch or what have you, I do feel like it has a pretty modern palette. And I think that a lot of that has to do with the fact that they are really based off of recipes from the countryside. Anyway, I love this book. It's so good. So if you guys get a chance, definitely pick it up. Hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you have any questions, please post below. Thanks so much, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.